Hello friends, in today's lecture of marketing research, we will study some of the introductory parts which include definition, type of marketing research, we will first see what is the research itself, then we will move forward about the types of research, and in between we will study some of the cases, some of the companies which use marketing research for their problem solving. When we start with our basic definition of research, the two basic keywords which define the research process in general . It is a systematic process, which means a system follows certain kind of steps. The system follows a certain kind of procedure. That is called systematic. So it is not ad hoc basis, on demand basis the steps are included or discontinued. It is a systematic process. It means if you want to conduct any research, then you have to follow a certain guidelines, a certain steps in between. The second term which comes in the definition research is objective, with a certain purpose in it. Every research has an objective, has a certain steps to follow to attain that objective, to do some market research, to do some research, and then present the outcomes, present the future implications, present your conclusion, your suggestions to the particular problem, to the management or to the higher authorities, or to, if you are a consultant, then to the client. Now if we redefine this process, there are certain additions to it. Systematic objective approach which identifies the steps of identification means you have to identify what the components, what the information you want to collect for the research process. So the steps involved in the research include the identification of specific problem aspects as well as the information components. Then you collect. Collect that information, bit of data from various identified solutions, from various defined sources. Now these defined sources can be of primary in nature. Primary means you can conduct a direct survey, a direct scheduled interview, a direct primary observation of the situation. May include the secondary sources as identification, the collection of data from the secondary sources, which can include the published sources. Published sources include reports. These reports can be industry reports, government reports, journals, academic journals, books, and other aspects. We will study this data collection part or this primary and secondary sources of data in a separate lecture or separate topic. But basically, this step includes the collection of components, information components. Once you have collected the bit of information or the data source from the data sources, then you want to apply tools for analysis. Now this step includes the analysis of information. Now the analysis of information includes various tools. Those tools can be of various softwares. The software can do tabulation of data, can be used to present the data in a graphical format, like Excel can be used for data tabulation, MS Excel, presentation of your data in a graphical format, in a chart, pie graph, chart, column. And a statistical analysis. So that software can include some statistical techniques which can be applied on the data to inference better results, to confirm your findings through a statistical tool. In our case, we will see some of the glints of a software called from IBM called SPSS. In later sections, we will study about how an SPSS can be used for statistical testing on the data. So broadly, a research will include identification, collection, and analysis of information. Distribution or dissemination means when you identify the problem, identify the sources from which you want to collect the data, then you collect the data from different sources and then analyze the data using different tools, and then you distribute that findings or conclusion to the management, to the required client or to the required person. So all these steps are applied to get out some relevant information. Now this information will be provided to management, will be distributed or disseminated to the required person, to the decision maker, to enhance their efficiency of decision making. So if we redefine it, research is a systematic and objective approach of identification, collection, analysis, distribution of information used for better or effective decision making. Now, this is a general definition of research. When we consider this or we redefine this definition for marketing perspective, and we can redefine this, that a marketing research is a systematic, objective approach that identify, collect, analyze, distribute information used for better decision making in marketing. So marketing may include different aspects. Decision making related to the brand, making related to product, price, place, promotion, people, and other aspects of marketing, communication. So, up to now we are clear that the marketing research is a systematic objective approach of analyzing, identification, collection, analysis and distribution of information for better decision making in marketing aspects, for better decision making in marketing. Now, we further see some of the examples that how this decision making process or how this marketing research help some of the companies to be more effective towards their, to be more responsible towards their customer. Some recent definition shows that the investigation of a problem in a systematic manner, that is the research, and it is ultimately for the betterment of organization and in last for the betterment of the society. One of the definition given by the marketing, American Marketing Association, is based or circulates around the basic component that we have highlighted earlier, is information. So marketing research, according to them, the process generate an information which is used to identify or define market opportunities and problems, generate and refine and evaluate marketing performance, and improve understanding of marketing as a process itself. So this is a definition given by American Marketing Association. So this aspect we have just covered, it's a systematic objective process of identification and identification and solving the problem, identification of opportunities and solving the problem in marketing. Now we will see how some of the companies use this marketing research for success in their products or in as in marketing. The company noticed an opportunity in a younger generation in which it has a similar market share. It is about Toyota Sion, one of the variant in Toyota. The problem the company is facing is regarding the sales. Problem what they are facing, that the sales is not going high, the given variant of the automobile is not accepted by the customer. To analyze the reason of that non-acceptance or non-adoption of this particular model by the customer, Toyota has hired consultancy and launched a project called Genesis to analyze the reason behind it. Now this research is a lot of qualitative in nature. Qualitative means it does not necessarily include the numerical data analysis aspect. You generally ask interview questions, informal discussions will happen with a specific focus group, may conduct a panel of interviews or a set of customers who are owning the Toyota vehicles. But the real problem is with the younger generation. So they constituted a focus group of this younger generation and identified the reason behind it. As you all know that our youth is already present in the online environment, they are very much fascinated about this online thing. So they use that same channel for data analysis and data collection process. They use internet surveys and use panel. Panel is a kind of a small set of group with a similar characteristics. Here the panel is of youth panel. So there is no mix of respondent or individual from different age groups. They are somehow belonging to the same age. The results are interesting. The generation Y values individuality, expression, diversity and style. So these are the characteristics they have identified. So this means your product should be stylish, your product should be unique, your product should reflect personality of the consumer. So it's an important finding that Toyota has identified, and they choose to advertise not for the traditional channel. That is, they go for a non-traditional channel, they go for internet marketing where the youth are there, they go for social media marketing where they can find their target customers, they go for live concerts, music events, and try to communicate their product to the younger generation. Redesign the entire model of Sion based on this consumer research, based on their consumer characteristics. So it means here the marketing research helps the company if we summarize it. Problem is with the sales. The approach to the marketing research consultant, through their survey, they found a specific characteristics of the consumer. They need stylish product, they need a product in which they can reflect their personality. The product should reflect the personality. They reflect the youth personality in the product. So they are able to identify the specific characteristics. And this marketing research or this research helps the company to redesign the name, the whole product. To identify the right channel for advertising or communicating to the customer. And to rightly position their brand to the minds of young customers. So they redesigned the whole model by a specific engineer and relaunch the product, re-advertise, re-communicate to the product in a new channel and try to reposition their brand to the younger customer to have a higher sale. Another example is related to a service called FedEx. The problem which they are facing are they are not able to identify the customers or the early information of the customers. They are not able to cater specific customer needs. So they approach the market, they identify what are the specific needs of a customer. In that analysis, they found that the customer requires a visibility in the system. Visibility means if you are a company like FedEx and I am a customer of FedEx, then I need a channel visibility. A channel visibility means, suppose I order a product from an online retailer. Support Flipkart. So this is a delivery channel. When you order, place an order in a Flipkart and the Flipkart has to deliver, suppose in 5 days period time. And Flipkart outsources the delivery process to FedEx. Now the Flipkart is also the outsource the delivery product to their FedEx. Then the FedEx has to carry your product to a channel, and channel may have some intermediaries or some location. Now the ownership or the transfer is related to FedEx. Then the FedEx should be able to track the product and provide information on this tracking information of product to the customer. So that customer, whenever they enter the order number to this Flipkart, that information will be provided to the customer that this particular day the the your shipment or your order has reached to Delhi, then this particular day it is reached to Calcutta, and then this particular day it is reaching to your location. And then this is the tentative day and time in which the parcel will arrive. Means, as a company, this channel, you are providing a channel. Now the channel should be responsible. Now the responsible means it should be provide visibility. And to provide visibility, you need an integrated system. Now integrated system means that a system should be implemented in your organization which will give a track location of that consignment at every stage. Now suppose the consignment or the shipment is from Delhi to Udaipur, then the company should be able to track at each location of the dispatch. Similarly, this information will be visible to the customer. Okay. If the customer is able to view that information, and if your system, because this system should be integrated, you cannot run separate software, you cannot run separate system at separate places. All the systems should have the same kind of software. All the system at every place should communicate with each other to get the right or to present the right number or the right information at every place. If the customer is able to track on his parcel, if your system is integrated, then your business becomes responsible. And it will enhance your image. This certainly had a profit for me. So, Madam is facing the same problem. They are not able to analyze this, what the customers are specifically want from the company. So, what this solution is provided by the research, that the customer needs more visibility in the channel. That result of marketing research helps the company to develop an integrated solution, to develop separate marketing tools or separate marketing communication systems for separate segments of the market. Now the research has also helped the FedEx to further segment the market also. So segmentation means when you classify the market into certain groups based on certain demographic variables. So when you classify the market on the demographic variables, suppose in the case of FedEx, I can segment my market on the basis of the type of consignment which is delivered. I can segment the market or the type of amount you are delivering. I can segment the market based on the quantity of dispatch orders you are placing to me. So for me, an individual customer can be a separate segment, but as an organization like Flipkart or online retailer like Snapdeal and Amazon, they are the major customers for me. So I am able to better. So that research has the FedEx to integrate the system more efficiently. So they develop this part called decision support system. So decision support system is a system which is highly sophisticated system to generate, a computerized system that generates information, that generates analysis report of the data, of the bulk of data, to help the decision making process of the manager, of the tracking device, tracking holder, of the supply chain manager in the FedEx, They have also developed a segment marketing system to more focus on an individual customer requirement. Similarly, in the case of McDonald's are facing the lawsuits of regarding their food quality. The allegation says that if their food quality doesn't have any nutritious value, it increases the obesity in the customer. So they hired this consultancy, Sandman and Associations, and they found that the customers of Americans are highly somewhat satisfied with the fast food industry, but there is an increase of awareness.
Okay.
So the results are awareness regarding health, nutrient value. The customers are more aware about their health issues and the nutrient value in the food. That is the result of that research, that the business has to transform itself, its offering. So the problem with lawsuits on the McDonald's has forced them to analyze what the customer wants. So they found that market research found that the awareness is increasing regarding the health and nutrition issues. So they have transformed their product and changed their food items, including the size of the plate, of the content itself, and the nutrient value. And as a result, we increase the nutrient value of the item, they introduce a salad part. So they surveyed around 400 respondents, interviewing through telephone or internet with wider demographic profile. And they ask the respondent to rate on a scale of 1 to 5. And this helped the changing in the total food items provided by the restaurant. As a consumer, I'm more concerned towards the health and nutrition value, and consumer are more aware towards the fast food offering in the restaurant. So this is the example of some company which use marketing research to solve their business problem, to solve their marketing related problems. Because the marketing research helps them to identify the basic causes of problems, to identify the basic customer needs and wants regarding their solution. And subsequently, the company has implemented that solution into their policies and modified their business policy and product offering to the customer, from the customer. Now we'll see what are two basic kinds of marketing research. When we classify marketing research on this basis, we can classify this marketing research into two kinds of research. Problem identification research and problem solving results. So the problem of identification research means a kind of research in which you want to explore the market, you want to explore the environment and to sense the existing problem. And if the problem is not present at a particular time, then what can be the future aspect or future problem that may exist? So identification includes market or environment analysis to sense the existing problem or a problem that may be or may arise in future. So if the problem may arise in future, that research should be possible or should have a potential to identify that kind of thing. So to sense or to identify that problem, there are certain kind of problem identification research that company will generally follow. Problem solving research are those research when you identify a problem, then you want to solve it. So this kind of approach or this kind of marketing research problem is conducted to provide the basic solution or to provide the solution of the problem. Will provide the basic steps that the company can adopt or company can implement to change the business functionality, to change how they perform or how they make function to be better or to solve that problem. So in the next session we will further discuss about what type of research will include in problem identification research. What type of research can be included in problem solving research and how and why companies are interested in identification and solving of research, solving of problems. And this will further lead us to the next part is of marketing process. If suppose the simple step initially for the business is first you identify the problem and then you try to solve the problem. Then the result or the conclusion will be arrived. Then you implement the solution. And then you evaluate the implementation. So this will guide us to further explain the marketing research process. So in the next session we will discuss what are the different kinds of identification and problem solving research and what are the different steps involved in marketing research process.